And good morning. Thank you for joining us today.
Good morning.
Go ahead.
I thought you were talking to me. I'm sorry. Good morning.
We are here with Mississippi's own Cassi Davis this morning. So you might better know her as Ella from House of Payne and as Bam from the Tyler Perry Madea movies. Mm-hmm. And so I am so happy to have her here to talk about a little bit about her life and what she's doing now. She is going to be in Biloxi on February 17th. I'm going to give you all the details on that a little bit later. So, Cassi, you're from Holly Springs, Mississippi. So you're one of our own. Tell us just a little bit about what it's like when you go back to visit Holly Springs. I understand you're in Atlanta today.
First of all, it's the booming metropolis of Holly Springs, Mississippi.
All right.
I have said it since I left home in 1984. But I tell you, you asked that question and I have so many ways to answer it. You said, what's it like when you go back home to visit? That word visit means so many different things to me because to me, I never really left because I go home often. I go the same way. So I know 20 and 78, now corridor 22. I know them like the back of my hand. I remember when we didn't have a freeway coming through to Birmingham. We would just have to go that back way and come up to 5 and do this and going in the back way, you know, so I've been visiting a long time, and every time I go, it relieves me. When I pull into and just get off right there at exit 30, when I get off at that exit, everything that I was bothered with just gets off me. I'm home then.
You're home.
Ain't nothing like being at home, baby.
Yep, and you're with your people. No better people you know, people you love.
In the world. Then the KFC and Halloween. Used to Coleman barbecue. You know, I ain't giving shout outs, but it's the truth. You got Anna Ruth's place right there on the square. I mean, you know, Tyson's drugstore. You know, everything is there. I mean, you know, it's home, y'all. My family's there. Mom, I grew up, you know, the writing on the back of the door when I was like 9, I was putting up there number 1 Leo. That's still on the back door. The back of my door. So I'm at home.
So it's food and family and love when you're
food, family, love, and family is just not inside the house.
Right.
You know, it's the community.
Yes.
You know, I mean, the mayor now used to be my next door neighbor. We used to play on the porch together.
Look at that.
Her family grew up with my family and the mayor before that and the mayor before that. We have relationships. And then you need not even bring up Russ College. You can't ask me nothing about Mississippi and Holly Springs and I ponder a thought.
Yes.
It just does not happen. I'm so excited to be I used your interview. Okay, you got questions. But I'm so excited to be coming home. I get excited every time. So I'm visiting Biloxi.
That's it.
I don't really visit when I go home.
So you have had just a rich and versatile career, film, television, on stage. One of the questions I want to know is, how did you originally connect with Tyler Perry?
It's a long story, and I know that I really want to go in depth on Saturday.
Okay.
In that conversation piece from 1 to 3.
Yeah.
Museum, okay, baby.
So are y'all hearing Cassi? She says she's going to share that story on the 17th. So you need to be there.
A brief thing. I was doing a favor for a friend that had wronged me. That's why you still got to do right by people.
Oh,
the blessing is in whether or not you do right, not whether you were done right. It's mm-hmm. true. But anyway, so I did that favor for the friend, and Mr. Perry came to see that show. And after the show, he came backstage and he was inquiring. And when he inquired, I was just a little hesitant because I was just not accustomed to the whole man in a dress.
Yeah.
Not from where I'm from.
Yes, I understand.
I'm still too blue the way I'm from. You know, my dad and them, they just weren't hearing that. And I was living in a box and living in a bubble. And I just had not experienced anything outside of what I came from. And I was not be deterred from what my rearing.
Yes.
You know, because the rearing is all we knew when we were growing up.
Yeah.
And so, got there and Mr. Perry pursued me, and then he asked about it, and I said, okay, yes, sir, I'll consider it. And then he said, 2.5 years later, Cassi, are you going to be a part of this or not? And I said, yes.
And there you go. So was Madea from Madea?
That was Madea Goes to Jail, the play.
Yes. All right. Awesome. Yes. Awesome. And as they would say, the rest is so much history. Congratulations on receiving the NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Actress in Comedy Show. That's a remarkable achievement.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
Now, how close is your real personality to your on-screen personality?
Wow.
Because you're so believable as an actor.
I think they're just one and the same. I think I'm fun in both places. I think I'm honest in both places. I think the difference is they script her on TV.
Yes.
And my real life does not have a script.
Of course.
And that's probably why I stay in trouble in my real life, because I probably need a script to keep my mouth shut a lot of times.
Well, just being able to flow out of that the fun that's inside of you, and to be so authentic, it comes across on the screen.
I appreciate it. I appreciate it so very much. I know I do have a big heart, and I love hard, and I love good, and I love right.
Look at that.
And I do. And I have fun all the time. I had a great childhood. It wasn't all, you know, it wasn't that everything that, I don't know. I don't know what anybody could ask for. But for me, I had a wonderful mom, wonderful dad, beautiful siblings. My community was great. You know, I still go home. I'm still friends with my old pastor, you know, that I grew up with. He's actually our cousin, Reverend F.H. Brown. You know, I'm still connected to Mississippi. You know, my mom and dad. My mom's from Ackerman, Mississippi. My dad's from Sturgis, Mississippi.
Yeah.
You know, so it's my heritage. It's my home. My state, you know, my aunt is still in Sturgis. Ain't ready.
And you know, I think people from a small town, we tend to be more authentic because that's what it's like.
Listen, coming up I'm married to my high school sweetheart.
Oh, look at that.
Are you kidding me? I was Miss Holly Springs High School and he was Mr. Holly Springs High School.
That's great.
Yeah, he was picking me up from band practice, you know.
Yes.
So I'm still friends with my classmates from that I graduated with in high school, you know.
That's
like
great.
We're still connected, you know. So when I am out and about and becoming these characters, or may liking or playing or acting, there really is a reality that I'm connected to that's a solid
and it keeps me rooted, it keeps you grounded. Yes, that's great.
And I don't have to pretend and may like over here.
That's right.
Life,
that's
like
make life. Make life. That's make a good life. Word. Make. I know what that means because I grew up in a small town.
Don't believe that. I ain't got the make life.
So when you talk about being rooted and grounded, your faith is such a significant part of your life. Talk about how that has impacted and helped you in your career, helped you in your health battle with Bell's palsy. Talk about that.
You can see it, huh?
Not really.
Oh, please, yeah, you can.
It's not that. Okay.
Hey, listen. It didn't stop me from talking. That morning I got up and I was brushing my teeth. And, you know, like when I don't like to say nasty thing, but when you discard the water from your mouth.
Yeah.
You know, I was discarding in the front and it went to the left. I'm like, well.
Hello, what happened
then
here?
I started looking and I was like, oh my God. My husband had just jotted out. He was going to the post office and I called him and said, listen, I'm going to the hospital. I think something is wrong with me. I think I'm having a stroke. He's like, what day is it? I was like, what the hell do we care about what day it is? I don't know what day it is. I don't know. Bloom, what day is it? I said, Kerry, it's Wednesday. He was like, okay, well, fool, I'm trying to see if you had a stroke. I'm trying to see, do you know dates? I was like, who thinks of that? Okay, well, baby, yes, yeah. When's your birthday? July 31st, 1966. Hey, not 1964. Like they have in Wikipedia.
Wikipedia, uh-huh.
It's okay, but I'm just 56.
Look, as you get older, those 2 years matter, honey.
I want them back. I haven't even had them yet. Yeah. Don't take them. Let me have them. I'm not dead yet. That's what I want to say. I'm not dead yet.
Yes.
But I'm telling you, Miss Wills, I can go on and on and on and on and on. You want me to continue on?
Well, yes, I want to know how it's helped you to be able to go through that, but also in your career.
Well, I tell you what, this is the bottom line. What's mine is mine.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I'm purposed. And I think God creates and allows everything to exist. Now, whether you church him or believe him, or, you know, I don't usually get into conversations about that. I just know who he is to me.
That's right.
And I know what he's done for me.
Yes.
I know who did it. I know how it got done. And I'm not through watching him do some more.
That's it. I got
so,
you. As they would say, bam.
Hey. I like what I believe.
Yes.
And I believe.
And you believe. have a comfort, and as
and
you
I
say,
do. And I'm very secure in it, because I've seen it work out to my advantage so many times. Today is Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
And happy Valentine's Day to all of the I sent to my family, to all of the swooning hearts, men and women. Happy Valentine's Day. But I tell you, though, I had a battle with Valentine's Day this is the attribute to, it's not always good. And it doesn't always feel good. And faith to faith to faith is work. But in the interim, God is still bigger than it all, and he provides. But I had a bout with Valentine's Day in 2016. Mm-hmm. My mom went home to be with the Lord on Valentine's Day.
Mm.
And I was just like, now, y'all just gonna mess up our Valentine's Day for the rest of our lives. We're never gonna get over this. We're never gonna be able to deal with a Valentine's Day and just be happy about it. And then I got a new appreciation. I started thinking about the relationship that my mama had with her maker.
Mm-hmm.
I remember seeing her sitting at the kitchen table, veering out up the street, praying morning after morning after morning. I remembered her in the United Methodist Women's Groups traveling to Camp Lake Stevens in Oxford and all around the Mississippi Delta and areas, you know, conducting and being a part of this women's group. I remember her, you know, being vice president of the women's group, and she would do this and that and the third. And I just had to remember that out of her own relationship with her maker, with her experiencing, you know, a failing heart and a failing health, what better day to have her heart healed?
Look at that. Look at that. Look at that.
So it just gets sweeter and sweeter the more bitter it is.
Yes.
And when you have purposed yourself to see things that way, it really doesn't matter to me what anybody thinks. I can't convince you. I can't. I can just tell you about it because it really did happen to me.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Wow.
So I don't debate. I watch the good and I watch the evil because it's present and it's always there. Always has been.
Yes. I just love how real you are. Just beautiful. It's beautiful. I hope that women who are watching you share today, they are encouraged in their authenticity to be themselves. It's okay to be the way that they are. Now, you know, I'm going to get off my soapbox because, you know, if I own a women's magazine, that I'm all about empowering women. So get off of that.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you. So, I told you at the onstart, I said, now I could flip this around and then begin to interview you, Ms. Wilson, because I know that, like I said, you didn't just start writing on yesterday and you didn't start composing and getting everything together just yesterday. So hats off to you. And thanks. I celebrate you for just even inviting me on and being a part of what you're doing.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
It really is an honor to cross paths because...
And I feel the same way.
Yeah. He designed this a long time ago and I didn't know why, and I still don't know why, but you know, just for us to make this verbal and this face-to-face
connection.
It means this connection. It just means something. And sometimes we don't know what.
It's an honor and a privilege. It's an honor and a privilege. Yes.
Thank you.
So you're going to be at the Oral Keefe February 17th.
Yes.
And this is part of their closed story exhibition in the African-American Gallery. So talk to me about the significance of coming to Biloxi and being in a part of this.
Well, you know, I don't really want to just be redundant with it's an honor, it's an honor, it's an honor. But you have to call a spade a spade. You can't cut if you play in spades. You can't cut with a hook.
That's right.
So I gotta be honest. It is an honor to be there. And I remember one time my mama said, whenever they call your name out, you better be there. I said, no, Ma, I don't wanna go because it's rigged and I don't think they gonna call my name no way. She said, I don't care what you think. This has been going on. She was talking about the NAACP. This has been going on for a long time. Black people been fighting for that moment. So if they call your name out,
yes,
you better have your tail in that seat. And I mean that. Yes,
mamas back then, they didn't play with that.
She did not play. She instructed me, and I'm still everywhere they calling my name out, I'm gonna try to be there.
Look,
so
at
Kenneth Green is the originator for this exhibit.
Mm-hmm.
And he has been just a champion in my life since I got back to Atlanta, Georgia, to complete my college career. And that was in 2007.
Okay.
And I graduated in 2009. And I was a senior for 21 years. But and he worked at Spelman College. So when Kenneth Green called, here we are years, now that's 2007, 2009, and here we are 2024. And he is a mogul and just a brilliant historian within his own right. And he's a creator and just a very diverse person. And he's so wise. And so he found a story behind the apparels and then put it together and actually connected with the people, you know, mm-hmm. who these garments belong to.
Yes.
So he's telling their story in
clothing, yeah.
In clothing, but in a museum, in an exhibit.
So this exhibit is about, it represents power, the power of women and their style and their presence.
And their grace and their intellect.
Yes.
And their wealth or not. And how regal they were, you know, at all times. It was just, you know, they were just, women were just so, African-American women have just been so poised
mm-hmm.
For such a long time. And this apparel that he has, these clothes, they represent so many things. I mean, from 1860 to 1963, come on.
Wow.
You know, like, okay, whew, to be a part of that?
You think about the African-American journey through slavery and wearing rags and never having anything really new. And so, you know, as a people, when we did have an opportunity to have nice clothes, there was a pride in that. It meant something deeper.
Yes.
To be able to have something nice to wear. So I know that the folks who come to visit the exhibit this week and the ones that catch you for lunch at the Ora O'Keeffe, that this is going to be a really special experience. If you're listening to us, don't miss this. This is going to be special. You already see the heart, the big heart that Cassi Davis has. And I know you want to hear, she's teased us. I know you want to hear the Tyler Perry story, the long version. Uh-oh. And so she catch lunch with her. The program is called A Conversation with Cassi Davis, The Dream of My Life. And it's from 1 to 3 p.m. February 17th. Tickets are available at georgeorr.org. Anything, any final words you want to leave the audience with, Cassi?
I just really want to reiterate what you said earlier. God did it.
Yes.
And I think that was before we got on the air. But God did do it. And the dream of my life continues. This is a part of it. So I'm just excited to be a part of this exhibit and coming to Biloxi. It's been a long time since I've been there, and I know everything is so different, and I cannot wait to get there.
We're looking forward to seeing you. We didn't tear the town down yesterday, Mardi Gras. We'll have everything clean up and ready for you.
Oh, no. No, let it stay like this. Let me see what y'all are looking like.
Thank you so much for the opportunity to share with you, to share with our audience. We appreciate you. We love all you have been able to accomplish. A big congratulations.
Same to
And we will see you on the 17th.
And this is 25 years for you?
No, I actually have been in the media business over 40 years.
Oh, it says connection.
Oh, this magazine. Yes, this magazine is celebrating 25 years.
Yes, that's what
this year. And there's such a beautiful story behind that I'll have to share with you.
Yes, yes, please.
Yes, yes. But the person, Dr. Angela Bruni, who started Gulf Coast Woman magazine, she was home she was on a maternity leave, and she was bored out of her mind. And she wanted something to do. And she told her husband about it. And he says, well, why don't you just do a community or church newsletter? And she showed him. As we said earlier, she did that. She went, look, with no journalism experience, no media experience, no design experience. Yes. None of that. She started this publication, and I came on board in 2012. And so, 2012 with the magazine, and we have just seen phenomenal growth. I'm so proud. We just hit 20,000 fan followers on our social media, but our footprint in this region is over 300,000 because we're not just in print. We are digital. We have a lot of digital formats that we're on. So.
Yes. And is she a Mississippian?
Yes. Actually, she's from a small town in Mississippi as well.
Oh, cool. Very good.
Up past Hattiesburg. Yes.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yes. Well, thank you again for joining us. This has just been beautiful.
No problem at all. I appreciate the time. I appreciate you allowing me coming on to share. And again, I am excited about this weekend.
Oh, awesome.